Hi all, today we will discuss 6A program. So 6A program is all about implementing the knapsack problem using dynamic programming. Okay, so here is the code for dynamic programming implementation for knapsack problem. So before we go into this, we will just solve a problem on dynamic programming using knapsack. Okay, suppose this is the problem given to you. Item numbers are given. We already know that what is knapsack problem. So in knapsack problem, a number of items will be given and corresponding weights will be given and corresponding profit will be given and maximum capacity of the bag will be given. So you have to put the items onto the bag in such a way that it should not exceed the capacity of the bag and you should yield the maximum profit. Okay. So, and this is also called a zero or one knapsack problem because we will place the item entirely onto the bag or we won't place the item onto the bag. Okay. So now to solve this problem, so we are going to apply this formula. Okay. So before that, I'll show you how to build a solution matrix. Okay. Solution matrix is built in this form. So when I say matrix, you'll think of how many rows and how many columns should be there. So for rows, we have to take n plus 1. What is n? N number of items given to you. In our example, what we took here, so there are 4 items. So we have to take n means 4. 4 plus 1 means 5 rows. Okay, observe here, we start the row number with 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, similarly, we have W plus 1 columns. What is W? W is the maximum capacity of the bag. So in the example which we have taken, maximum capacity of the bag is 5. So how many columns we have to make here? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So totally 6 columns. We started with 0. Okay, so and row is marked with I. I indicates the number of items. Okay, item numbers, and J indicates the residual capacity of the bag. So like this, we have to build a matrix first with these many rows and these many columns. So what we fill in this matrix is the profit which we are going to earn on placing that item onto the bag. Okay, so profit, or we call it as value. So that is indicated by the matrix entries. Okay, so with this, we shall see how to fill this matrix first. Okay, so we will apply these three formulas. So we when we say value V of 0 comma J, so 0 comma J means 0th row and J columns. 0th row, J columns will be filled with 0. What is the meaning of this? Okay, I is equal to 0 means literally there is no items. When there are no items, can we place it onto the bag? No. So when we don't place any items onto the bag, what will be the profit? It will be 0. Okay, so entire row, 0th row, and all the columns are filled with 0. So first step, what you have to do is this. And the next formula which we are going to see here is V of I comma 0. I comma 0 in the sense items are there, but J is 0. J in the sense residual capacity of the bag. When there is no bag at all, J is equal to 0 means there is no bag. When there is no bag, can we fill the items onto the bag? No, we cannot fill the item. So when we don't fill the item, do we get any profit? No, we are not going to get any profit. So this entire column will be filled with 0. Okay, all rows and 0th column will be filled with the entries 0. Okay, so next we have to follow this formula. So for what does the formula says? For example, so WI indicates weight of the particular item. Okay, and J indicates the residual capacity or the remaining capacity of the bag. We will take each and every item. So individual items we are going to take. Suppose if we take the first item, what is the weight of first item? So weight of the first item is 2. Okay, 2, is it less than the residual capacity of the bag? We will check. So if the item weight is less than the remaining capacity of the bag, it means that we can put that item onto the bag. So when we add that item onto the bag, we will get some profit. So how do you calculate that profit? You'll okay, so we are greeding towards earning the maximum profit, right? So we have to use this formula. Compare the previous row with the same column profit along with the newly added profit. So when you compare these two, whichever is maximum, so that value you are going to place it in this matrix. Okay, So, and similarly, one more case we are checking. So, if the item weight is greater than the capacity of the bag, suppose we have 2 kg of item, but bag capacity is 1 kg. Can we fill that item onto the bag? No, you cannot place that item onto the bag. So, what value we will be filling? So, this is V of I minus 1 comma j is the value we are going to fill it into the matrix. So, based on these three formulas, we are going to build this matrix. Okay, observe here. Okay, so let's take the first zeroth row, first row with the first column. What is the entry we need to fill here? First item, it is in our hand. Can we fill that item onto the bag with the capacity 1? Okay, just look at the item weight. So first item is having 2 is the weight of first item. So can we place that item with weight 2 in 1 kg bag? No, you cannot place. So what will be the value filled here? Previous row, same column. What is the value? Previous row, same column. That is 0. So 0 you are going to fill here. Similarly, you take first row with the second column. So first row means one item is available. First item is available and 2 kg of bag is there. Okay, so can we place first item with weight 2 kgs into the bag having the capacity 2 kg? Yes, we can place. Okay, when we are going to place that item onto the bag, what is the profit associated with that is 12. Okay, so this 12 will be filled into the matrix like this. Okay, so similarly, so one item is available, 3 kg bag is available. Item, first item weight is 2 and the bag's weight is 3. Can we fill that item? Yes. So we will place the profit 12 here. Okay. So the procedure continues like this. And if you fill the matrix by using this method, so we will get the solution matrix like this. Okay. So, and at the last row, at fourth row and fifth row, whatever the, at fourth row and fifth column, whatever the value you will get, that is 37. So this will be your optimal profit. Okay. So these are the things which you have to remember while implementing your knapsack problem by using dynamic programming technique. Okay. So now let's see the code. Okay, let's see the code, how we are going to implement this program. Okay, so as usual, as we all know, public class knapsack DP is the class name which we have taken. So function we are going to implement, that is called as solve. Okay, so, and what are the inputs? What inputs we require for solving this is weight of the individual items, value or profit corresponding to this individual item, W indicates capacity of the bag. This indicates your number of items given to you. Okay, so these are the inputs we require. So I'm coming to the function. So we are declaring a matrix, which we call it a solution matrix, which I have shown you earlier. That is, V was the matrix. Okay, here it is taken as solution matrix. So how many rows and how many columns you have to construct? That is N plus 1 rows and W plus 1 columns. N plus 1 row means it is number of items which you have taken plus 1. Okay, in our previous example, that is 4 plus 1, 5 rows we have constructed. And W plus 1 is capacity of the bag plus 1. Capacity of the bag was 5. 5 plus 1, it is 6. Okay, 6 columns we are going to construct. Okay, so this is the memory allocation we are doing for the matrix. Okay, so now we are varying the for loop to fill the entire matrix. Okay, so... And you should observe here, one thing is I less than or equal to n is there. So I varying from 0 to n, equal to n, it is very important because we are creating n plus 1 rows. Similarly, j less than or equal to w, that is w plus 1 columns we are going to create. Like this, we are going to fill the entries of the matrix. Coming to the first if condition, so we have here is I is equal to 0 or j is equal to 0. If the item is not available or if the bag is not available, you fill that row and column number, row and column with the value 0. So that is what we have shown in the example. So 0th row, it is filled completely with 0 for all columns, and j is equal to 0 means literally there is no bag at all. Can you fill the items? No. So entire column will be filled with 0. So that is the meaning of the solution of I, j is equal to 0. Next, we have one more condition, that is weight of that item. weight of the item if it is greater than the capacity of the bag. Okay, so suppose residual capacity is indicated by J. So if the capacity of the bag is 3 kg and item weight is more than that, that is 4 kg of item if it is available, 4 kg of item if it is available, and bag capacity is 3. Can you fill that item onto the bag? No, definitely we cannot fill the item. So then what we have to do, go to previous row in the same column, whatever the value is there, copy that value to current matrix position. That is solution of ij is equal to solution of I minus 1 comma j. Okay. Else we have one more option for doing that. Suppose if the item weight is less than the bag capacity, definitely we can place that item onto the bag. Okay. So while you are placing that item onto the bag, you should check whether the previous entry, previous row with same column entry has got the maximum profit, or the newly placed item is gaining us more profit. Okay. So compare these two, whichever is maximum, you place that value onto the solution array. Okay. Solution array. So this will be repeated until you cover all the entries in the matrix. Okay. So finally, we are going to get the optimal solution here. So finally, we are going to get the optimal solution in nth row and wth column. Okay. So and next part of the program tells us on placing what items we got this profit, optimal profit. So to work with that, so we shall take one more array. We call it a selected array. Selected array shows us what are the items we have selected for placing onto the bag to gain this optimal solution. Okay. So initially thinking that none of the elements are placed onto the bag, so selected of I, this array entries are made with zero. Zero indicates none of the items are placed. If any entry in the selected array changes from zero to one, it means that that particular item we have placed onto the bag. Okay. So and coming to this logic. Okay, so where we start with I is equal to N and J is equal to W. So I is equal to N and J is equal to W means why we have to initialize to this is, I'll go back to the problem where we have solved. Okay, so just observe here. So if you want to look at the item which we have placed onto the bag, okay, so take the last entry in the matrix, compare this entry with the previous row same column entry. Okay, so what we can observe here, 32 is the entry here we have, and 37 is the entry here we have. When you compare these two values, we will find a small gain in the profit, right? Okay, they are not same entries. It means that on adding some items, we have increased the profit from 32 to 37. Okay, so it means which item I have added? Look at the... Okay. So we were seeing how on adding which items we got the profit to calculate that. So just compare the fourth row and fifth column entry, that is the last entry, which is the optimal profit we got, that with the previous row same column entry 32. So we are comparing these two values whether they are equal or not. No, since 32 is not equal to 37, it means that there is a rise in the profit on adding certain item onto the bag. Okay, so now we will see how to check which item is added. Okay, since there is a raise in the profit, on adding fourth item, we got this raise. Okay, so so we will come to know that. So fourth item is added onto the bag. Okay, and similarly, okay, after knowing fourth item is added onto the bag, okay, so how to check whether the next item is added on to the bag or not? Before that, so on adding fourth item, so bag capacity was 5. After adding fourth item, weight of this fourth item I have to take out to calculate the residual capacity of the bag. So that is maximum capacity was 5. After placing fourth item, what is the remaining capacity of the bag? Weight of the fourth item is 2. 5 minus 2, it is 3. 3 becomes the remaining capacity of the bag. So now what we need to do is, you take the previous row, go to third column. Okay, so that is 22 is the value here. Okay, and next row, compare the value in third column. Is 22 equal to 22? Yes, it is equal. Okay, there is no raise in the profit here. Okay, it means that third item is not added onto the bag. Third item is not added onto the bag. Okay, so since there is no items added, there is no change in the bags weight. So what we have to do, go to previous row and the next previous row. So compare these two values. Okay, 12 is compared with 22. Is there, are they equal? No, they are not equal. This shows there is a rise in the profit on adding second item onto the bag. Okay, so second item is added onto the bag. Okay, so since second item is added onto the bag, what was the previous residual capacity? 3 was the previous residual capacity. Second item is added onto the bag. Second item weight is 1. So 3 minus 1, it is 2. What is the residual or remaining capacity of the bag now? It is 2. Okay. So after calculating this, now just look in second column, because the residual capacity we have now is 2. Okay. So second column we have to see, and we are just checking whether first item is placed onto the bag or not. Okay, so you see it in second column, first row, and its previous row with the same column. Now see, is there any increase in the profit? Yes, definitely is there, because previous row is having the value 0, so now it is having 12. So it means there is a slight increase in the profit. On adding which item did we get this increase in the profit? That is first item. So now what are the items placed onto the bag? Fourth item, okay, second item, and first item is placed onto the bag. Okay, so like this we will calculate what are the items placed onto the bag. Okay, now let's get back to the code. Okay, I'll show you what is written in the code. Okay, so just observe this. So this entries or this part of the code will tell you which items are added into the bag, how to find it. Okay, I is equal to n and j is equal to w is there. So we have to initialize I and j to the end row and end column values, because we start tracking from that position. Okay, so and we are repeating this until I becomes 0 and j becomes 0, means until I cover all the items and then until I cover the capacity of the bag. Okay, so what I'm checking now, if solution of ij, is it less than or equal to solution of I minus 1 comma j? I showed you, I shown you, right? So same column, previous row entry. So previous row entry means I minus 1 I'll take. So I'll compare its value. If they are not equal, I understand that on adding certain item, I got increase in the profit. So what I'll do, I'll make that item entry in the selected array as 1. So previously it was 0, indicating that this item was not selected or not added onto the bag. Now if I change the entry value from 0 to 1, it means that I have added the item onto the bag. Next, as soon as I add the item onto the bag, I'll calculate the remaining capacity also. How to calculate the remaining capacity of the bag? That is j is equal to j minus weight of that particular item. Okay, so and I'll repeat this until I get I cover all the items given in the problem. Okay, so I gets decremented because I was initialized to n. Okay, so I'll decrement the items and this loop gets repeated, and finally you're going to print the items which are placed onto the bag. What is the code for printing the items onto the bag? So I already said you, selected array contains either the entries like 0 or 1. Okay, so if it is 0, that particular item is not placed. If it is 1, so we are going to print that item. Okay, so like this we are going to implement, and finally in the main function. So we are creating the object of this particular class. By using that object, we are going to collect the inputs like n, weight of the item, profit of the item, or we also call it as value. So like this. So from here to here, we are going to read the values for inputs. Okay, so n value we are reading, and weight of the corresponding items we are reading, and profit of the corresponding items are read. And we also read what is the maximum capacity of the bag. So after reading all these inputs, we will supply these inputs to the function which we have written earlier, which is called as solve function. Okay, so as soon as we call the solve member function, its control immediately shift to this and executes the program. Okay, so now let's see the execution of the program. Okay, let's execute this. Okay, so once you execute this, it asks for number of elements. I'll give the same input which we have taken in our example. Okay, so in the previous example, we have taken four items. Okay, so four items I'm going to give. And what is the... Okay, what is the value, what is the weight of the items? 2. Okay, weight of first item, weight of second item, weight of third item, okay, weight of fourth item. Okay, similarly, what is the profit associated with those items? I'll give now 10, 12, suppose 20 and 45. So this is the profit, and back capacity, I'll give it as 5. Okay, so what are the items selected? 1, 2, 4. What is the optimal solution we have? 67. Only last entry we are printing. If you want, you can also print the matrix. Okay, entire matrix you can print, or just the last row and last column entry, it is taken as optimal solution. Okay, so this is about knapsack problem implementing by using dynamic programming technique.